Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to class 9th of Indus Valley Public School, Rat, where we will be doing lesson number 3 from your Moments book. That is, the name of the lesson is Ishwaran the Storyteller by R.K. Lakshman. So, in this story, we are going to study about Ishwaran, who was the storyteller. And before that, I would like to give a small description about the writer. So, R.K. Lakshman, his full name was Rashipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Lakshman, and he was an Indian cartoonist, illustrator, and humorist. He is best known for his creation, The Common Man, and for his daily cartoon strip. So, whenever he used to narrate the story, he used to narrate the story in such a manner, in such a fashion, that everybody, whosoever is listening to him, they feel that it is something, real thing is happening in front of their eyes. He was so good in narrating the stories. So, my dear children, here in this lesson, we have two characters, Mahendra, he was the junior supervisor, and Ishwaran, the cook. Ishwaran is the cook for Mahendra. So now, the title of this chapter, Ishwaran the Storyteller, tells us that this story is about whom? Ishwaran. He is called the storyteller because as storytelling is an art. So he is very good at it. Who? Ishwaran. Ishwaran uses special effects, voice modulation, uses his body language to make the story realistic so that the listener, that is Mahendra, because Mahendra used to listen his stories, get attracted and captivated in his stories. The writer wants to highlight his quality of Ishwaran, that he was so good at telling stories that they appeared to be real. The stories were a source of entertainment for Mahendra because Mahendra used to stay all alone and nobody was accompanying him, only the cook, and the name of the cook was Ishwaran, and he used to cook food for him, he used to wash the uniform cloth for him, and even in the night he used to talk to Mahendra. Okay children, now moving to the lesson. So, here is your lesson, Ishwaran the Storyteller. One night, Mahendra woke up from his sleep and saw a dark, cloudy form. He broke out into a cold sweat. Was it a ghost? So, Mahendra, he was sleeping and suddenly he woke up from his sleep, and what he saw? He saw a dark, cloudy form and he was not able to recognize what it is. And he was sweating a lot after seeing that, and his body turned cold. And he was so much frightened after seeing that dark, cloudy form. So now, was it a ghost? It's a suspense. So in order to break this suspense, let's read the lesson. So here is your first paragraph. The story was narrated to Ganesh by a young man, Mahendra by name. So now Mahendra is delivering the story. He is telling the story to a person, to a fellow, and a young man, and his name is Ganesh. He was junior supervisor in a firm which offered on hire supervisors at various types of construction sites, factories, bridge, dams, and so on. So Mahendra was a junior supervisor and he used to supervise various construction sites such as factories, bridge, dams, and so on. Mahendra's job was to keep an eye on the activities at the work site. So he used to observe various kind of work that is done in the work area. He had to keep moving from place to place every now and then as ordered by his head office, like from a coal mining area to a rail bridge construction site, from there after a few months to a chemical plant, which on coming up somewhere. So now what happened? As per the instructions given by the head office, Mahendra used to move from different one place to another place. It can be a coal mining area, or it can be a railway bridge construction area, or any area. He has to move as per told by the head office. Okay. Now coming to the second paragraph. So he was a bachelor. Bachelor means he was not a married person. Who? Mahendra. His needs were simple and he was able to adjust himself to all kinds of odd conditions. Odd conditions means unfavorable conditions. The conditions which are not according to him. So he was very simple person and he used to adjust in any kind of situation. Whether it was an ill-equipped circuit house or a makeshift canvas tent in the middle of the stone quarry. So here makeshift means temporary houses and quarry means mine. Mine matlab jo aapka khadan hota hai, theek hai? So he used to stay at any house, the house which are not permanent, there also he can easily stay. He can also stay at a place where mine is there. So he can adjust in any kind of situation. But one asset he had was his cook, Ishwaran. So he was saying the one advantage, one good thing he was having, that was Ishwaran, his cook. The cook was quite attached to Mahendra and followed him uncomplainingly wherever he was posted. He cooked for Mahendra, washed his clothes and chatted away with his master at night. He could weave out endless stories and anecdotes on various subjects. Anecdotes means a short, amusing or interesting story about a real incident or person. So now what happened? So Mahendra used to cook for Ishwaran used to cook food for Mahendra. He used to wash his clothes. He used to talk to Mahendra in the night. And even he used to deliver very good stories to him on various subjects. Okay. Now coming to the third paragraph. Ishwaran also had an amazing capacity to produce vegetables and cooking ingredients. Seemingly out of now, in the middle of desolate landscape, with no shops visible for miles around, he would miraculously conjure up the most delicious dishes made from fresh vegetables within an hour of arriving at the zinc sheet shelter at the new workplace. So now Mahendra is telling to Ganesh that Ishwaran was a great cook. Whenever they shift to a new location, Ishwaran would gather all the vegetables and ingredients required to him for cooking, and he used to cook in within no time, very less time he used to take for cooking, as they lived at a place which was not habited by many people, in a temporary shelters with roofs made of metallic sheet. जो आपने देखी होगी ना, आपके छत के ऊपर जो एक शीट डाल दी जाती है, दैट वे ही टिन शेड जो कहते हैं, उस तरह के हाउसेस में वो लोग रहते थे. इट सीम्स एज इफ ही वुड डू सम मैजिक एंड गैदर ऑल द इंग्रेडिएंट्स आउट ऑफ नोवेयर. सो वो ऐसे कुछ मैजिक से पकाता था कि खाना बहुत डिलीशियस बन जाता था. महेंद्र वुड बी अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग एंड लीव फॉर वर्क आफ्टर ब्रेकफास्ट कैरिंग सम प्रिपेयर्ड फूड विद हिम. सो महेंद्र यूज्ड टू गेट अप अर्ली एज ही हैज टू गो टू द ऑफिस and he takes his lunch along with him. So meanwhile, Ishwaran would tidy up the shed, wash the clothes and have a leisurely bath, pouring several buckets of water over his head, muttering a prayer all the while. It would be lunchtime by then. So what happened meanwhile, when Mahendra used to go to the school office, then this Ishwaran, what he used to do? He will clean the shed, he will wash the clothes and he will take the bath, leisurely bath, with long hours bath. Okay. And what he will do after that, and then before and while taking bath, he used to say some prayers also. Now, itna sab karne ke baad, it would be a lunch time. So, after eating, he would read for a while before dozing off. So, after having the lunch, he will read some books and then he will go to sleep. So, which kind of books he used to read? Let's see. The books was usually some popular Tamil thriller running to hundreds of pages. So it was a Tamil thriller books which he used to read. Its imaginative description and narrative flourish would hold Ishwaran enthralled. Enthrall means the state of being in someone's power. So he used to get into the story so much that he used to capture himself in the characters that are running in the stories. वो उसी कैरेक्टर में डूब जाता था, इतने अच्छे से पढ़ता था वो स्टोरीज को. सो नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ. हिज ओन डिस्क्रिप्शन वर ग्रेटली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द तमिल ऑथर दैट ही रीड. व्हेन ही वाज नरेटिंग इवन द स्मॉलेस्ट ऑफ इंसिडेंट ही वुड ट्राई टू वर्क इन सस्पेंस एंड अ सरप्राइज एंडिंग इन टू द अकाउंट. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, ही यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब ऑल द स्टोरीज इन अ वेरी good manner, and he used to create the suspense also in the story. Even a small incident he will not say directly, he will turn and twist the stories and he will narrate the story in order to generate suspense, in order to generate the curiosity and all. For example, instead of saying that he had come across an uprooted tree on the highway, he would say, मतलब एक सिंपल सी बात है कि वो एक ऐसी जगह पे आया जहाँ पे उसने हाईवे पे अप्रूट किया ट्री को, वो ये डायरेक्टली ना कह के सी हाउ ही इज गोइंग टू से. ही वुड से विद आईब्रो स्वीटेबली आर्क्ड एंड हैंड हेल्ड्स आउट इन अ ड्रामेटिक गेस्चर. सो ही हैव टर्न द स्टोरी इन अ वेरी सस्पेंस मैनर. द रोड वॉज डेजर्टेड एंड आई वॉज ऑल अलोन. सो ही सेइंग ही वॉज मूविंग टू अ प्लेस विच वॉज ऑलरेडी deserted. No, that means nobody was there on that place. It was fully vacant place. Deserted means empty place. Okay. Suddenly I spotted something that looked like an enormous bushy beast lying sprawled across the road. So now that uprooted tree ko kaise wo define kar raha, enormous bushy beast, like a huge bushy beast, ek bahut bhayanak sa लार्ज सा बीस्ट वहां पड़ा हुआ है. ओके, आई वॉज हाफ इंक्लाइन टू टर्न एंड गो बैक, बट एज आई केम क्लोजर आई सॉ दैट इट वॉज फॉलन ट्री विद इट्स ड्राई ब्रांचेस स्प्रेड आउट. सो नाउ ही इज सेइंग दैट बिफोर आई वॉज अबाउट टू लीव, ईश्वरन इज सेइंग कि आई हैव सीन अ ह्यूज बीस्ट अक्रॉस द रोड, एंड जैसे मैंने थोड़ा झुक के देखा, आई वॉज अबाउट टू लीव, आई फाउंड दैट इट वॉज अ ट्री, नथिंग मोर देन दैट. सो उसने ट्री को कितने उसमें ह्यूमर क्यूरियोसिटी वे और सस्पेंस वे से उसे बताया है कि लोग पहले डर जाए उससे. महेंद्र वुड स्ट्रेच हिमसेल्फ बैक इन हिज कैनवास चेयर एंड लिसन टू ईश्वरन टेल्स अनक्रिटिकली. सो महेंद्र वुड हैव बीन, ही यूज्ड टू लिसन हिम वेरी साइलेंटली एंड ही वुड नॉट से एनीथिंग, वेरी क्वाइटली ही यूज्ड टू लिसन हिज स्टोरीज एंड he was sitting there, he will be sitting on his canvas chair. Coming to the next paragraph, the place I come from is famous for timber, Ishwaran would begin. So now Ishwar start telling the stories and he is saying that ki I belong to a place which is very famous for timber. What do you mean by timber? Timber is a wood that has been processed for commercial purpose. मतलब कि लकड़ी का जो टुकड़ा होता है उसको इस तरह से प्रोसेस किया जाता है ताकि वो हम उसको बिजनेस पर्पज से यूज़ कर सकें. There is a richly wooded forest all around. The logs are hauled on to the lorries by elephant. Hauled means transported. They are huge, well fed beast. When they turn wild, even the most experienced Malhout is not able to control them. Malhout is a person who used to take care of the elephant. After this prologue, Ishwar would launch into an elaborate anecdote involving an elephant. Prologue means an introductory speech, and elaborate means detailed. So now what happened here? So Mahendra recollect another story told by Ishwaran. Ishwaran said that his native village was surrounded by a huge forest which was full of trees. The huge log of timber was sold for business purpose. They were transported onto the vehicle by elephant that elephant used to carry. They were huge elephant, and if they became mad, means who became mad? Elephant. They would not be controlled and the Mahout would not be able to tame them. Mahout, the person who used to, who used to take care of the elephant. This introductory session was followed by a detailed story involving an elephant. So now this story was about his place, village where timber was there, and it also included the elephant. One day a tusker escaped from the timber yard and began to roam about. Tusker here means an elephant. Stamping on bushes, tearing up wild creepers and breaking branches at will. You know, sir, how an elephant behaves when it goes mad. Ishwaran would get so caught up in the excitement of his story that he would get up from the floor and jump about, stamping his feet in emulation of the mad elephant. So stamping means hitting the floor with his feet. And emulation means effort to match or surpass a person by imitating or copying. जैसे हम जैसे कि किसी का दिखाना है पागलपन, सो ही सेम वे ही स्टार्टेड डूइंग द थिंग. किसी का डांस किसी को इमिटेट करके तो शो करते हैं, दैट इज़ व्हाट एमुलेशन. ओके, सो हियर इन दिस पैराग्राफ इट इज़ टोल्ड दैट कि अगेन द स्टोरी वॉज नरेटेड, जो हमारी आगे स्टोरी चल रही थी टिम्बर वाली, वो कंटिन्यू करता है ईश्वर, एंड ही वॉज टेलिंग दैट वन डे एन एलिफेंट एस्केप फ्रॉम द टिम्बर यार्ड एंड रोम्ड अराउंड द फॉरेस्ट. इट इज स्टेप्ड ऑन द बुशेस एंड क्रश्ड देम, tore the creeper plants and broke branches of trees which came in its way. And Ishwaran asked Mahendra whether he knew how a mad elephant behaved. So in order to make his story more effective, what Ishwaran did? Ishwaran stood up and jumped around the place, hitting the foot on the ground in order to copy the actions that will be done by the mad elephant. Okay? Fine. Coming to the next paragraph, the elephant reached the outskirts of our town, breaking the fences down like matchstick. He would continue. It came into the main road and smashed all the stalls selling fruits, mud pots and clothes. People ran helter shelter. Helter shelter means here and there in panic. The elephant now enter a school ground where children were playing, breaking through the brick wall. All the boys ran into the classrooms and shut the doors tight. The beast grunted and wandered about, pulling out the football goal post, tearing down the volleyball net, kicking and flattening the drum kept for water, and uprooting the shrubs. Meanwhile, all the teachers had climbed up to the terrace of the school building. From there, they helplessly watched the depredation of the elephant. There was not a soul below on the ground. The street was empty, as if the inhabitants of the entire town had suddenly disappeared. So now here, all the disasters, all the destruction done by the elephant is narrated. Okay, so what Mahendran is saying, let's see. So now Ishwaran. So Ishwaran is saying that as the elephant reached out of the boundary of their town, it broke the fences. The fences seemed as if they were like matchstick of the huge elephant. The elephant reached the main road and broke all the stalls selling fruits. मतलब जितनी भी वहाँ पे shops थी fruits की, mud pot की, cloths की, everything was destroyed. The people were taken unaware, and so they ran here and there. Then it broke the wall of a school. Who broke? Elephant broke the wall of the school, and it entered the ground where children were playing. And after seeing that elephant, all the children ran back into their classroom and they closed the door very tightly. The elephant made a loud noise and roamed around the school ground. It broke the goalpost of the football. Then he tore the net that had been kept for volleyball court and stepped into the water drum. And what it did, it broke and tore many plants as well. The teachers who were there in the school, they climbed onto the roof of the school building and watched helplessly, because nobody was able to control that mad elephant. And by seeing this elephant had destroyed the school property, and there was not even a single person to be seen around, and all the streets of the town were empty, as all the people was scared of the mad elephant. Okay. So now coming to the next paragraph. I was studying in the junior class at that time and was watching the whole drama from the rooftop. So now who is I? Here I is Ishwaran. So he is saying that when all the situation was going on, all the scene was going on, I was in the junior class and I was seeing from the rooftop. I don't know what came over me suddenly. I grabbed a cane from the hand of one of the teachers and ran down the stairs and into the open. The elephant grunted and menacingly swung a branch of a tree which it held in its trunk. It stamped its feet, kicking up a lot of mud and dust. It looked frightening, but I moved slowly towards it, stick in hand. People were watching the scene, hypnotized from nearby house top. The elephant looked at me red-eyed, ready to rush towards me. It lifted its trunk and thumped loudly. At that moment, I moved forward and, mustering all my force, whacked its third toenail on the quick. The beast looked stunned for a moment. Then I shivered from head to foot and collapsed. So, hypnotize, it means to influence, control or direct completely as by person, charms, word or domination. Jusiko bolte na, hypnotize kar lena, vash mein kar lena, that is the meaning of this thing. Mastering means putting together. So now, whacked, hit noisily by a stick. Collapsed means to fell down. So now what time? Now in this paragraph it is told that ki when all this thing incident was going on, so Ishwaran, he told that he was in one of the junior classes and he was watching the elephant from the rooftop. Suddenly he took the stick from one of the teacher and ran downstairs towards the school ground. The elephant made a very loud noise when he saw a small boy approaching towards it. It lifted the branch of a tree in its trunk, hit its foot on the ground, which threw a lot of mud and dust in the air. The elephant was threatening Ishwaran, but the boy was not afraid of it. With the stick in his hand, he moved towards the elephant. Slowly, many people had climbed onto the rooftop of their houses and were watching the incident. They were standing still and were awestruck, waiting to see what happened next. Ishwaran saw that the elephant had red eyes, which were full of anger. It again lifted the trunk and made a loud thump sound as it was about to attack Ishwaran. Then Ishwaran gathered all his force and hit the elephant's third toenail quickly. The elephant was stunned at what had happened. Then it reacted and shivered all over, fainted and fell on the ground unconscious. So he became unconscious at that time. Now, at this point, Ishwaran would leave the story unfinished and get up mumbling, "I will be back after lighting the gas and warming up the dinner." So now, after telling this much, he went to the kitchen and he said, "Okay, I will be back after warming up the dinner." Who said this thing? Ishwaran said to the Mahendra. Mahendra, who had been listening with rapt attention, would be left hanging when he returned. Ishwaran would not pick up the thread of the story right away. Mahendra would have to remind him that the conclusion was pending. Well, a veterinary doctor was summoned to revive the animal. Ishwaran was shrugged casually. 2 days later, it was led away by its mahout to the jungle. So now what happened? Rapt attention is completely fascinated. He was absolutely absorbed in the story. And then pick up the thread of the story means would not start the story from where he left in order to arouse the curiosity. And now veterinary doctor means animal doctor. Someone means to call. Shrugged to raise one shoulder slightly and momentarily to express doubt, ignorance or indifference. So now what happened? After the Ishwaran would leave the story incomplete, in a low voice he would say that he would return after lighting the gas stove to warm the dinner as they were getting late for the dinner meal. So Mahendra would be curious to know what happened next and would feel disappointed that Ishwar had left the story in between, incomplete. Okay. So now on returning, Ishwaran will not continue the story as he wanted to arouse curiosity in Mahendra. So what Mahendra? So Mahendra would begin, would be eager to know the ending of the story. So he would ask Ishwaran to conclude the story. Ishwaran would say casually that a veterinarian doctor was called to bring the elephant back to unconscious, and after 2 days, the Mahout would take the elephant back to the jungle. Okay, so what this is the story. He said, what was the end? End mein kya hota hai ki a doctor, animal doctor is called in order to control the elephant, and after that, after 2 days or after some days, Mahout will be called in order to take the elephant to the jungle back. Okay, now coming to the next. Well, how did you manage to do it, Ishwaran? How did you bring down the beast? It was something to do with the Japanese art. I think, sir, karate or jujitsu, it is called. I had read about it somewhere. It temporarily paralyzes the nervous system, you see. So now what Mahendra was curious to know, that how did young Ishwaran manage to overpower a huge elephant? Okay, because he said that I hit it on his third toe, I had hit it the toenail of the elephant and he became unconscious. So Mahendra want to know, how did this Ishwaran control that elephant? So now he is saying that, Ishwaran replied that he performed a Japanese martial art. Which art? Japanese martial art. He said it was either karate or jujitsu. He had read about it somewhere that the martial art rendered a person unconsciously by disrupting the nervous system. Okay, now coming to the next. Not a day passed without Ishwaran recounting some stories packed with adventure, horror and suspense. Whether the story was incredible or not, Mahendra enjoyed listening to it because of the imitable way in which it was told. Ishwaran seemed to more than make up the absence of a TV in Mahendra's living quarter. So, credible means able to be believed, convincing, and imitable means unique. Okay, so every day Ishwaran would narrate one or the other story full of adventure, horror, or thrill. Sometimes Mahendra felt that the story was a fiction, but still he enjoyed listening to it because of the unique way in which Ishwaran used to tell, Ishwaran used to narrate it. As there was no television set at the place where they used to live, so these stories were a source of recreation or entertainment for Mahendra. Now coming to the next. One morning when Mahendra was having breakfast, Ishwaran asked, "Can I make something special for dinner tonight, sir? After all, today is an auspicious day. According to tradition, we prepare various delicacies to feed the spirit of our ancestors today, sir." So now auspicious is good. Delicacies means tasty foods, spirit, soul of the dead, and ancestors, elderly of the family. So now one morning, Mahendra was having his breakfast. So suddenly Ishwaran asked him whether he can prepare some special meal for the dinner, as it is a good day. And he added that on that day they prepared special food for the souls of the dead people, of the dead elderly people of the family. So that night Mahendra enjoyed the most delicious dinner and complimented Ishwaran on his culinary skill. He seemed very pleased, but unexpectedly launched into a most garnished account involving the supernatural. So culinary skills mean related to cooking. Garnish, something which is too colorful and fancy that he disliked. Supernatural, it means related to ghost and spirit here. So here Ishwaran had prepared a very delicious dinner and Mahendra praised his cooking also. Ishwaran was happy on being praised, but all of a sudden started narrating a detailed story related to ghost and supernatural power which were disliked by Mahendra. Now next, you know sir, this entire factory area our occupying was once a burial ground, he started. Mahendra was jerked out of the pleasant reverie he had drifted into after the satisfying meal. I knew on the first day itself when I saw a human skull lying on the path. Even though I come across a number of skulls and bones, Ishwar continued. So what is there in this paragraph? Reverie means a state of being pleasantly lost in one's thought, or you can say a daydream. So now Ishwaran said to Mahendra that this factory area, this site was full of a place where dead people used to get buried. So Mahendra jerked out. Means he jumped out of the present thought after tasty meal. मतलब अचानक से झटके से उड़ गया कि ये क्या सुन रहा हूँ मैं. Ishwaran continued that on the first day itself he had seen a human skull and this skull was lying on the ground when he was returning after buying vegetables. Even later he had come across a number of skulls and bones lying around the place. So he started telling all the ghost wala thing to Mahendra. Then what happened, let's see. See, he is telling, no, Ishwaran is coming, then he has seen skull, bone and everything. See the picture. So now next paragraph, he went on to narrate how he sometimes saw ghost at night. I am not easily frightened by these things, sir. I am a brave fellow, but one horrible ghost of woman which appears off and on at midnight during the full moon. It is an ugly creature with matted hair and shriveled face, like a skeleton holding a fetus in its arm. The shriveled means wrinkled and shrunken. वो जो सिकड़ी हुई जो आपकी बो स्किन हो जाती है ना, सिकुड़ जाती है, दैट वे. फोटर्स एंड अनबॉर्न बेबी. सो ना ईश्वरन एडेड दैट समटाइम्स ही यूज टू सॉ घोस्ट एट नाइट ऑल दो ही वॉज नॉट स्केयर्ड ऑफ दैम एज ही वॉज अ ब्रेव पर्सन बट वंस वट ही सॉ अ हॉरिबल घोस्ट ऑफ अ वोमेन इट अपियर्ड ऑन अ फुल मून नाइट एट 12 o'clock. सी हाउ ही इज मेकिंग द स्टोरी, यू नो. इट वॉज वेरी अग्ली. हु वॉज अग्ली? दैट वोमेन had matted hair and shrunken, withered face. It looked like a skeleton holding an unborn baby in its arm. Mahendra shivered at the description and interrupted rather sharply. You are crazy, Ishwaran. There are no such things as ghosts or spirits. It is all a figment of your imagination. Get your digestive system examined and maybe your head as well. You are talking nonsense. So here figment means production. So Mahendra disliked the story and interrupted sharply. He scolded Ishwaran and said that he had gone mad. Mahendra said the ghost did not exist. He added that it was Ishwaran's imaginations. He ordered Ishwaran to get himself checked up, to get his digestive system and his brain examined, as he was speaking nonsense. Mahendra asked him to get his digestive system checked up because when a person is suffering from constipation, he get nightmare and dream of ghost and supernatural parts. Coming to the next, he left the room and retired for the night, expecting Ishwaran to sulk for a couple of days. But the next morning he was surprised to find the cook as cheerful and talkative as ever. Sulk means be silent. So now what happened? Mahendra had thought that Ishwaran would remain quiet for a few days as he had scolded him previous night. But what was the thing? It was just opposite. He was astonished to see a cheerful and talkative Ishwaran the next morning. In the same way he find. So there was no change in Ishwaran. Next thing. From that day, Mahendra, for all his brave talk, went to bed with a certain unease. Every night he peered into the darkness outside through the window next to his bed, trying to make sure that there was no movement in the dark shape in the vicinity. But he could not but he could only see a sea of darkness with the twinkling lights of the factory miles away. So vicinity means nearby. So Mahendra showed that he was very brave, but on the contrary he was uneasy because of the story narrated by the Ishwaran. Every night before going to bed, he peeped out of the window next to his bed to assure himself that there was no ghost around. He did not see any ghost, but only saw darkness and twinkling lights of the factory. He had always liked to admire the milk-white landscape on the full moon nights, but after hearing Ishwaran's story of the female ghost, he avoided looking out of the window altogether when the full moon was. So before listening to the story narrated by the Ishwaran, Mahendra light watching, he used to watch the white colored landscape on a full moon night. As Ishwaran told me that Ishwaran told him that on the full moon night a female ghost haunted place, and he stopped looking out at night as he saw afraid bumping into ugly ghost. So now Mahendra was scared to look out on the full moon night, because Ishwaran told that on full moon night a lady ghost used to come. So now he stopped enjoying all that thing. Now what happened? One night Mahendra was woken up from his sleep by a low moon close to his window. At first he put it down to a cat prowling around for a mice, but the sound was too guttural for a cat. He resisted the curiosity to look out, lest he should behold a sight which would stop his heart. But the wailing became louder and less feline. He could not resist the temptation anymore. Lowering himself to the level of the window's sill, he looked out at the white sheet of moonlight outside. There, not too far away, was a dark, cloudy form clutching a bundle. Mahendra broke into cold sweat and fell back on the pillow, panting. As he gradually recovered from the ghastly experience, he began to reason with himself. He finally concluded that it must have been some sort of auto-suggestion, some trick that his subconscious had played on him. So my dear children, moan means crying sound, prowling, searching, guttural sound produced in the short or harsh sound. Wailing means crying sound. Feline, related to cats or other family members of the cat. Panting, breathing heavily, ghastly, causing horror and fear. And auto-suggest means subconscious adaptation of an idea which one has originated himself. So now in this paragraph it is told that Mahendra was sleeping one night and he was awakened by the sound of some crying. He thought that it would be a cat looking for a mice and tried to go back to sleep. The sound became more harsh and seemed to be a human sound. Mahendra wanted to peep out of the window but stopped himself as he was afraid that he saw a ghost. He could even die. The crying sound became louder and it did not appear to be the sound of a cat. Mahendra could not stop himself, and so he bent down and lifted his head slightly in order to peep out. In the white colored moonlight, Mahendra saw the ghost. It was holding a bundle in one hand. Mahendra panicked. He was breathing heavily and fell back on the bed. After some time, he recovered from the scary experience and thought that probably his subconscious mind was showing him the ghost as he had been thinking of it. He assured himself that actually there was no ghost and his mind was playing a trick on him. Okay, so this is there. Now next one. By the time he had got up in the morning, had a bath and come out to have his breakfast, the horror of the previous night has faded from his memory. So everything is gone from his memory. Ishwaran greeted him at the door with his lunch packet and his bag. Just as Mahendra was stepping out, Ishwaran grinned and said, "Sir, remember the other day when I was telling you about a female ghost with a foetus in its arm? You were so angry with me for imagining things. Well, you saw her yourself last night. I came running, hearing the sound of mourning that was coming from your room." So Greenwich smiled broadly, resolving mean deciding. Haunted place means visited by ghost. So now what happened? By the time Mahendra woke up, took his bath and came out for breakfast, he had forgotten the ghostly experience of the previous night. Now Ishwaran greeted him, gave him his lunch and his bag. Now Mahendra was about to leave. Ishwaran smiled and said that other day Mahendra had scolded him for discussing the ugly ghost, but the last night Mahendra himself saw it. Ishwaran had heard Mahendra's cries the previous night. A chill went down Mahendra's spine. He did not wait for Ishwaran to complete his sentence. He hurried away to his office and handed in his paper, resolving to leave the haunted place the very next day. So now what happens? Spine means backbone. Resolving means deciding. Handed me this paper means resigned. So what happened? Ishwaran's comment scared Mahendra once again. He did not hear Ishwaran. He did not make Ishwaran to complete the sentences and hurried himself towards the office. Then he decided to resign from the job and leave the haunted place. He could not live there any longer. So this is what there in the story. So this thing, no, Mahendra was very much scared by the story narrated by Ishwaran, and due to that he left the job, he resigned that place and he went away from that particular location. So now just see how Ishwaran had delivered the story, how he had generated a real sense in the story. So this is a smartness that he did. Okay children, now go through the lesson, read the lesson once more, go through the explanation part also, and till then, bye bye, take care and thank you so much.